In the beginning, God created the universe and man in his image, and wished him to live in peace with his kind. But no matter how advanced civilization became, warfare was still a part of life. Then, in a distant galaxy, a great conquering warrior changed mankind's history. His name was Kroger the First. He was to become the most powerful and feared king throughout his galaxy, and peace would pervade all the land. As the story is told, he became fascinated with the planet Earth. Then, in their 16th century, although considered primitive, their customs, their manners, and especially their women fascinated him. And so it was that King Kroger the First chose for himself the perfect woman. With his lovely chosen queen, the dynasty was established and was passed on from father to son, until...
And that is why I say we of the council cannot, nay, will not, wait any longer for our beloved and regal king to act on the subject of marriage and an heir. I insist that we confront the king, forcing him to resolve these two issues before the king's first cousin, Prince Edward, comes of age.
Archbishop Talk is correct, good counselors. The king must establish his lineage. The king must have a rightful heir. Otherwise, upon his death, his young cousin Edward will seize the crown. And our futures, all of ours, will be most uncertain.
But, Prime Minister, approaching the king on this matter will not be easy.
As Finance Minister, I see things from a purely practical point of view. If Edward's little twit took over the crown, there would be nothing but chaos. And I recommend that King Kroger marry someone like the great-granddaughter of King Lufsa.
Lufsa, an army of weaklings. Give me King Martian's army, and I'll give you all the financial stability you need.
Let me finish. Let me finish.
Council members, the last time we brought up marriage to our king, he wasn't exactly agreeable to it. And if we proceed...
We must act today.
Yes, yes, General. We understand your theory that military might is the answer to all problems. But let us put aside the speculation as to whom might or might not be the ideal queen and try to convince our beloved king that he must marry and give us an heir.
But consider the king's feelings on the subject.
The issue shall be decided. I propose we summon the king. Mordal?
Agreed.
Agreed.
I agree.
Summon the king.
But I don't...
Call the king!
Summon the king now!
Well, sir, I...
Now! Now!
Yes, sir! Yes, sir!
I hate doing this.
You hate doing this?
The last time I interrupted the king at this hour, he nearly had me deported. Emo, I want you to relay the council's request to the king. You go in first.
Why me? I'm your assistant.
That's why you. You're my assistant.
But see... All right. The gods have mercy. But remember, this is your idea.
What a woman.
Je ne savais rien, je ne sentais rien. Je n'existais pas. Maintenant, Rodolphe, je te remercie.
Tais-toi, je t'en supplie.
Que vient-il?
What a woman. I could fall in love with a woman like that.
Mais je te suivrai.
The women around the Zuko could take a lesson from her, huh?
Je te suivrai.
Huh?
Oh, yeah, yes.
Yes, Your Highness.
Là d'où l'on ne revient pas.
Great King.
Shh.
Dear benevolent ruler.
Avec toi.
Sir, it's important.
Permets-moi de te
présenter. It had better be important. You're interrupting my show.
Yes, sir. They want to talk to you about your taking a queen.
Pas le temps.
queen?
Oh, it must be that time of Legon again, to interrupt my show with a request like that. So the council wants to discuss the queen?
Yeah.
Tell him I'm not interested.
But master, if we can't at least persuade you to discuss it with them, we'll lose face.
Oh, forgive me. Oh, noble, wonderful king. Oh, honorable master of the galaxies.
So the council wants to discuss marriage.
Yes, sir.
All right, for the sake of my two trusted friends, I will go and speak to them. You see, I have nothing against marriage. It's just that I enjoy being a bachelor. Too young to be married. The truth is, the council is concerned about what they're going to do if something should happen to me. You see, the council is looking out for themselves. Where are they?
In the main council room.
Let's go and have this out once and for all.
What a show. What sentiment?
Margaret Modano?
Yes, Margaret Madonna, the unmarried sister of King Yusef, who I understand is a devoutly religious person, which is an excellent quality for a queen. She will rule with a pure heart. Therefore, I submit for your consideration, Margaret of Yusef.
Ugh, Margaret of Yusef. You tell me how a gentle heart gets out of this.
You crazy? Don't be so demonstrative, you
see? Physical strength always wins over gentle hearts.
Mordo, you can be so crude at times.
But, sire, I was only making a point.
That your strength lies in your arms and not in your brain.
But, sire.
Now, what is this request you wish to make of your king?
Your lordship, the council is united this time and has resolved to put forth a recommendation of marriage for the sole purpose of ensuring a legitimate heir to the crown.
Yes, yes, this I know. Go on.
When your illustrious ancestor, King Kroger I, conquered this land, he set in motion an unbroken chain of descendants. This chapter provides that this unbroken chain be based upon a legitimate son of the ruling king.
Yes, yes.
You, sire, you are the last living ruler. That means without a son, you will be breaking the lineage established legends ago.
And if you have no heir, my lord, and something, God forbid, should happen to you, your cousin Edward will lay claim to the crown.
This is true, isn't it?
Edward becomes legally of age this trice moon.
So soon?
And your highness, you're not getting any younger.
You think so?
Sire, when King Kroger I was your age, he had 3 children and 7 grandchildren. Now, would you really want your uncle's son, Prince Edward, to take over your reign?
Yes, it wouldn't seem right to turn it over to,
a sissy? Our very concern, sire.
Yes, the thought of him wearing the king's clothes.
Well, sire, I'm more worried about him wearing the queen's clothes.
Yes, I know what you mean. You have convinced me. I shall have an heir.
This is the glorious day. Our king, King Kroger VIII, has decided to take unto himself a queen.
Long live the king!
Long live the king!
Long live the king!
This day, this wonderful day of decision, I pledge to my people to continue the long tradition of the great and honored Kroger I. I will take a wife. Under one condition.
Anything that pleases you.
The most important decision is that you have agreed to the council's proposal.
My condition is that my wife be chosen from the planet Earth.
Those barbarians, they're still in the atomic age, sire.
Tell us, you jest at me, King.
I do not. I mean it.
Yes, he does. Especially the women from that place on Earth called America. He loves American women.
Gentle nobles, perhaps we have made enough progress for one day. May I suggest we adjourn?
Ridiculous. What kind of an alliance would that be?
We would be laughed out of the galaxy. Earth is thousands of legons behind us. It's primitive.
Very primitive.
Change to have a wild, primitive woman. If nothing else, it would be a wild and crazy experience. Come in, sit down.
Your Highness, can you hear me?
Yes.
There are certain requirements the Council feels would be desirable from a diplomatic point of view.
What?
There are certain qualities desirable for the Queen, Your Highness.
Yes, exactly my thinking. We're looking, for a perfect woman, of course.
I agree.
She should be a model of perfect health, congeniality, attractive.
I think we should talk about specific requirements.
Yes, a nice figure.
What I meant is, qualities like education, poise, sophistication.
Yes, of course, she should have, Zig, are you there?
Yes, Your Highness.
Zig!
He's here.
Make a list of the Council's requests. After all, she will be the people's queen also.
Sire?
Mm-hmm.
There is one point more. One little stipulation the Council requests, if thou wilt grant it. Agree, my king?
What? Could you speak up?
The Council has a little request, sire.
Yes, of course. Your king is a considerate man. Their queen shall be a beautiful, soft, lovely, adoring queen. What is the request?
If the queen is to be perfect in the tradition of our benevolent King Kroger, the first queen, she will have a small beauty mark in the shape of a crescent moon next to her navel.
Yes, her navel.
Of course, the Council would appreciate being kept abreast of all the other details.
What?
Keep them abreast.
Abreast? So be it. Zig, write it all down. I'll affix my seal.
Our benevolent king will affix his seal to this decree. Thank you, Your Highness.
Don't you think this beauty mark will hamper the king's chances of finding an Earth queen?
It will certainly put a crimp in it.
It certainly will. What's a beauty mark?
It is done.
It is done!
So the king accepted the Council's one requirement?
He did, dear Talk. And I have the king's word to confirm it. Your suggestion was quite brilliant, if I do admit.
Quite brilliant?
The chance of finding this Earth woman with that mark are one in a million.
Good. Now, we send Zig and Emo on this Earth mission to find this perfect woman.
Yeah.
Zig, look at this thing. Isn't that interesting?
Very interesting.
It's a clever idea they've got there.
I wonder what on earth they use this long cloth for.
For drying your hands.
Blowing your nose.
Keeping your chest warm.
Will you help me with this thing?
Yeah, sure. If you'll help me with this, help.
Okay.
I think you just stuff that right in there.
In it goes.
Good.
And up.
Ah. Good. Okay.
You know, Emo, it occurs to me that we've never had to pretend to be Earth people, to dress up to look like them.
I know. I feel like I'm going to a costume party. It was easier just to sneak things from Earth whenever the king needed anything.
Well,
how's this?
A bit primitive, but you look passable. Emo, I believe that closing mechanism goes in the front.
Oh.
Oh, Dick, let me help you tie that thing. Now, remember, along with all the other requirements, you may exclude any of the candidates that do not have the described mark. Is that understood?
Yes, Your Counselorship.
Yes. There. Now, since this is the first time you will have to interact with Earth people and be believed as one of them, I've prepared some special instructions which include identification cards, money, and a book on the English language, all necessary to conceal your unearthly identity. You'll be passing as business executors. Now, remember, you are looking for a queen, a woman to share the crown of this glorious empire.
We will overlook nothing. Nothing.
I'm sure you won't. Now may the gods of Zuko make your trip safe.
We are ready on automatic takeoff procedure.
Right plane adjustment. 0.081. Sequence added down.
Everything is ready in here.
Zig, this is your king speaking.
Yes, Your Royal Highness.
Yes, sir.
I will be following your progress with great interest.
Yes, sir.
You know how important this mission is to me.
Oh, we do, Your Lordship.
I want to be kept informed.
Affirmative, Your Kingship.
Is that all, sir?
Yes. May the gods of Zuko be with you.
Stand by.
How are you doing? How are you doing? Put her there. You say as you extend your hand to the Earth person.
Well, we're on our way.
Put her there.
Put what where?
No, see, they put theirs there, and then they clasp hands and they pump up and down.
Who are you talking about?
The Earth people. Then there's, hi, what's up? Of course, there's also, hey, what's going down? Or you can just, put your hand on the shoulder of the other being and say, how do you feel? Of course, you can just smile and say, what do you say?
What do you say?
That's what they say. What do you say?
You say, what do you say?
That's what I said. They say.
You said, they say, what do you say?
Exactly what I said. They say, what do you say? I don't say, what do you
say? Forget it. Forget it. Forget it.
Sorry. They also touch lips on occasion.
Will you slow down? You can clasp hands, you can touch lips, and then you say whatever it is you said.
Sometimes they just touch lips for a long while. That's right, we've seen that on the King's TV. Earth men and women touching lips and music plays.
It seems very odd.
Earth people mate that way. Are you sure? No.
Come on. There's the road. Let's just get up there.
Zig.
What?
I think there are moving things in here.
There's an Earth person now. Let's ask her for help.
Hi. Put her there.
Put what where?
Hi. How's your doing?
Enough of your kidding. Would you kind of help me now, please?
Can you take us to town?
Yeah, if you can get it started.
Did you bring a lanometer?
No.
Well, there's only one thing to do.
Right. Get in the pilot seat.
Acknowledge. Prepare for launch.
Ionic accelerator set.
Ready for ignition countdown.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
We have ignition.
Blast off!
I'll drive, thank you.
I don't want to hear any more about your being from another world.
And we're here for an important mission.
Yes, to find the perfect woman for our king.
That's the first time I ever heard that line.
You don't think Earth women will believe us?
Maybe we better come up with another line. Julie, you can let us out anywhere.
Anywhere?
Yes. We're looking for an office.
Well, you better find a real estate agent.
Gentlemen, you're going to love this place. Follow me, please. Did you hear about the janitor strike? Right here, fellas. Huh? What do you think? Oh, looks like somebody knew you were coming. It's right over here. Oh, clean up just a bit. This is the best office in the building, I'll tell you, fellas. 100 bucks.
How's that?
100 smackaroos, in advance.
Oh, excuse me.
Oh, I see you guys are going to be a little tough, huh? Okay, 80 clams.
I'm sorry, sir, we don't have any clams.
Don't you carry any dough?
We do have a little bread.
How much?
Enough for two sandwiches.
Will you take money?
Are you kidding?
Sorry, we're just asking.
I get it. I should have known the costumes. You're a comedy team. And darn funny, too, huh? Okay. $75.
Oh, you should have just asked.
That's some funny stick you guys do. Funny stick. You guys are really pulling my leg.
We didn't touch you, sir.
Where's he from?
A test tube.
Test tube? Hey, no screaming in this comedy tube. You're both funny. That's funny stick. I'll see you guys. Enough for two sandwiches.
He's a happy person, isn't he?
We have got work to do.
Yeah, you're right. There's a lot to do before tomorrow.
I think we should take out an ad.
Yes, good idea.
How about something like wanted woman? Excellent figure, attractive, 25 to 35, good public speaker, hostess, well-educated, single, to be assistant to head of a company.
Here's my card in case you're interested in a little real estate, maybe a little snug apartment, huh? Don't I know you from somewhere? You look familiar. Maybe not. Oh, you know these guys? They are so funny. I'm friends with both of them, and I can probably put in a good word for you. Now, that's an outfit. That is an outfit. Oh, gorgeous. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
What's up?
How are you?
How's your doing?
Fine, thanks.
Excuse me, I'm curious. What sign are you?
Huh? What sign were you born under?
Sign? I don't remember seeing any sign.
I mean astrological sign.
You're a Capricorn, aren't you? I'm a double Taurus myself.
Oh, well, I'm a single zirconian.
A what?
Never mind.
Are you into phrenology?
Huh?
This is fantastic. Fantastic.
What's fantastic?
You have so much hair. A little dandruff.
Would you put his head down, please?
Now, about that position.
Let's touch lips.
Do I have to type?
No.
Take shorthand?
No.
Dictation?
No.
Answer phones? File?
No.
No? Terrific! Could you give me something specific you're looking for?
Oh, yes. A beauty mark. Right there.
You're a Scorpio. I should have known.
Bless you, Husky. Go, you Husky. Fight to win the game. Crash him, Husky. Crash him, Husky. For the glory and the fame. Whee!
Uh-huh. Yes, that's very interesting. Tell me, why do you shake so much when you sing?
That's what I did when I was queen.
Queen?
Queen?
You were a queen?
I was chosen queen of the Huskies 2 years straight.
Huskies?
Queen of the annual Husky Day parade.
Oh, tell me, when you were a queen, was that all you were asked to do? Just sing and, shake?
Well, Mr. Bender, the manager of the Huskies, he wanted me to do some other personal favors for him, but I'm not that kind of girl.
Does this job require traveling?
Yes.
How far?
You'd have to go further than, further than you've ever gone before.
You sound a lot like Mr. Bender.
Oh, the manager of the Huskies.
Oh, you know him.
Thank you very much.
We appreciate your company.
Guys, I have never seen so many tomatoes in all my... Hello, hello. What do we have here? You guys didn't tell me, huh? Listen, I want to get the phone number of that chair you just left a few minutes ago. Hold that. Look no further, Foxy Lady. You guys have been holding on me. Huh? Have we met somewhere before? Alex Schmorg, real estate broker at your service. What'd I say?
You said Alex Schmorg, real estate broker at your service.
Huh. Funny. Forgive us for disturbing you, Your Highness. We realize that it's 48 cycles since Zig and Emo left, but the Council would like to discuss possible alternatives.
Of all people, you should have faith, Tuck.
But it harms nothing to think about alternatives, my lord.
The alternative, sire.
You'd be happy to know that King Poco's daughter would be honored to be considered as your bride.
That spindle-legged, simple-minded twit.
But her father's kingdom is rich and powerful.
And she makes the Wicked Witch of the North look glamorous.
What Wicked Witch of what North?
From the Land of Oz. You know, the Wizard of Oz.
What galaxy is Oz?
Never mind, Tuck.
Zig, we must have seen over 200 females.
Out of all this, I don't think we have three good finalists.
I know. And then we didn't even check to see if they had that little, you know, that little mark.
We'll do it after we find somebody good enough to be a finalist. Then, if the council approves, we'll worry about the mark.
Yes, you're right, Zig.
Well, let's get to it.
All right.
Kind of like this one. But the king might like her.
Yes, she was very good in every way. But she talked oddly, remember? I was educated at the University of Tucson.
Oh, yes. That's how the king's cousin talks. You know how the king feels about him. Well, this one looks promising. Well educated, qualifications are good, even worked with some of Earth's leaders of states.
Ah, forget it. She's what they call a one-nighter. Lady of the evening.
A what?
Hold it. A hooker.
Emo, in our language.
Oh! She's a no-no lady.
Oh, no. Emo, there's not one that has a perfect score.
What'll we do?
I don't know. I guess the great gods of Zuko weren't with us today.
Yes?
Come in!
Excuse me, I don't mean to bother you, but my car has a problem and Zig? Emo, is that you?
Yes. And aren't you Julie?
Yeah.
I remember. You're the one with the crazy machine.
And you're the one from outer space.
Uh-huh.
Can I use your telephone, please? Thanks. Don't let me interrupt you. You know, go ahead.
Yes.
Oh, it's busy. Can I stay here a few minutes? Do you mind?
Fine, sure.
Okay. Boy, you two look like a couple of wet noodles.
We do?
My feet hurt.
It's been very stressful here.
What are you doing? You looking for the perfect woman still?
Yes.
Well, looks like you're casting one of those movies.
Here's our act. Read it if you like.
Oh, I never would have guessed. Seems like an odd place to be interviewing women for an executive position. I thought you two were looking for a queen to take away on your flying saucer.
Well, we didn't want to attract too much attention.
You know, this ad doesn't even stress the qualities you should be looking for.
You're right.
Yes, a beauty mark is also important.
No, but you should be looking at experience.
experience.
Yes, look, experience in... politics, foreign relations, diplomatic procedures, organizing receptions. Now that's important.
Yes.
Yes.
Look, I don't mean to interfere in your business, but you see my point. Beauty's only skin deep. You should be looking for someone with more important qualities.
Right. Like a beauty mark.
Oh. I think you two are going about this the wrong way. Let me show you what I mean. See, when a woman answers an ad like this, emphasizing her figure, you're giving her the wrong idea. It's as if you're looking for a beauty queen.
Yes, a queen. We told you.
Now look, let me show you what I mean, okay? Hello, handsome. Little helpless me is here to apply for your position. See, is that the kind of woman you want?
Yes, yes. Show me again.
Emo.
Sorry.
Me too. You're so naive. I think I'm pretty sure what you're looking for. Maybe you'd like me to find this woman for you,
I think you already did.
Would you mind standing in front of our little basket? Hold still and smile.
What? What is that?
Zig and Emo have assured the council of a fine choice.
No matter how delicate the matter, these men have never failed me. Let's be on with it. Your king wants to see what you brought him.
Your Royal Highness, good counselors of the king, we return with the first stage of our mission completed. We have interviewed hundreds of possible candidates, many of whom are very well qualified. But as we agreed before we left, we would only select those that had the qualifications set down by you, lords and ladies. Fortunately, we have found such a perfect woman. Now, are we ready? Your Royal Highness, as you requested, we have her on image scan. You may proceed.
Ah, now this is Julie of Earth.
She's beautiful.
Very.
As I was
very
decent looking.
Now the qualifications of being physically attractive and having what you call a good body.
What a body.
Fascinating.
It's relevant to what the qualities are of the girl that you're looking for. You see, to me, I think it's important that she should have a strong spiritual foundation.
Those lips.
She should be practical in the business sense.
Those eyes.
A woman can still be feminine and be equal to any man in education, business, or even physically.
Yes. I'm in love.
You're looking for an exceptional woman to fill a very important position.
Quite interesting. Don't you think, Your Highness?
Your Highness?
That face. She's lovely.
Counsel, how you vote?
Agreed.
Agreed.
Agreed. Agreed. Gentlemen and gentlewomen, if this woman is not wearing the necessary mark, then the king will have to accept the council's choice for a queen. Sire.
Whatever pleases the council. Zig, Emo, don't let me down. I must have that woman. Is that understood?
Zig? Zig?
What is it?
Do you remember all the points that the council wanted?
Here they are.
Thank you. Well, Tonk wants to have proof of her loyalty, her high morals, her physical fitness, and then the biggie.
How are we going to make sure she has a beauty mark without offending Julie? She'll think that all we care about is her body. You know how she feels about that.
I know. I thought about it. There's really only one thing we can do.
What?
Become Zuko's first peeping Toms.
Wow.
Hey, come on. Thank you very much.
Boy, this is kind of you. It's a nice vehicle.
Wild ride, man.
Yeah, man.
Fire out.
Those things are dangerous.
Come on, Emo. Be quiet.
This just doesn't seem like the right thing to do. Go. Just stay down. Let me find the bush. Come on. There, over there. Where do I go now? Just keep in sight. Behind the car. Come on, let's go. Okay. Get down. I'm coming.
You said you saw it done on one of Earth's TV shows.
I did. I also remember they got caught.
But they didn't have the great gods of Zuko behind them.
It still makes me nervous, Zig. Come on, let's go down. Wait. Hey, listen. I hear water running from up there. Now, I'll give you all of them. And you look through the window. Getting over a little more to the left.
Okay, buddy, what's going on?
Oh, hello. We're looking for something.
Yes, we lost our Zot meter.
Yes, and I think it fell up here.
A Zot meter, huh? Well, what is that?
A measuring device.
Right, and we lost it up here.
Yes, and he was measuring how high the window was. How high is it, Emo?
Oh, it's 84,000 Zots. I think. I better recheck.
Okay, knock it off. Give me some identification.
Oh, yes.
Let me see your driver's license.
Drive? Oh, well, we wouldn't drive one of those things. We fly.
Oh, you fly. Well, how would you two jokers like to fly downtown?
Zig? Emo?
Hello, Julie.
Officer, what's going on here?
You tell her, Emo. It was your idea.
Emo, what are you doing?
Well, you see, Julie,
I caught these two trying to look through your window.
Oh, Emo, Zig, what am I going to do with you? Officer, thank you. I'll be responsible for everything. Bye-bye. Will you please come down here and tell me what this is all about? I know you wanted to see if I was home, so you were embarrassed to ring the doorbell, is that right?
Doorbell?
Oh, you boy. You're the craziest man I've met in the people I've ever seen. Come on. Listen, Arthur. Will you sit down?
Yes.
First, you almost ruined my car. Then you tell me you're from outer space. Well, how's the search going?
Oh, very well. All your advice was a big help. We're very close to the candidate.
Oh, yes, very close.
We need a little bit more information.
We still need to uncover a few things.
If I can help.
Oh, you sure could.
Just ask. I'm gonna go get some coffee. Okay.
Listen, where are you staying?
Staying?
Uh-huh.
We don't have a place to stay yet.
No, we're only going to be here for a couple of days.
I have a wonderful idea. Why don't you stay in my extra room?
I don't know.
I insist. I have the room.
Well, thank you, Julie. You're very generous.
Well, it'll give me a chance to see how your project is going, and I can fix you one of my special dishes.
Oh, is it broken?
Oh, Emo, stop. I'm gonna go fix some coffee. Now tell me more about yourself.
Well, there isn't much to tell. We've already said we're from a long way off.
Yes, a long way off. But you don't believe us.
Well, where'd you go to school?
School?
Education.
Oh, we were educated by computers.
That's interesting. Do you have family?
No, I was a clone.
You mean a clown. Class clown?
No, class clone.
By the way, if you want to powder your nose, the little boys' room is the second door to the left.
The little boys' room?
You know, powder room. The John. The restroom.
Mom! The resting room.
I'm not tired just now. Maybe a little later.
Well, if you need to go, you know where it is.
What is this strange room she's talking about with all the funny names? Like powder room.
That sounds very mysterious. You better check it out.
Why me?
Go now.
Julie, excuse me for a moment. I'm gonna go rest now in the little powder room.
The coffee's ready. Here's your coffee. You drank all the cream. Where's the sugar?
Oh, we like that a lot.
Aren't you gonna save some for Emo? Where is Emo?
He went to the little boy's resting room.
Knowing Emo, I hope he doesn't fall in.
Fall? Is it dangerous?
You know, you guys are wacko. Sometimes I think you are from another world.
Another world? That's right. That's exactly what we've been trying to tell you.
Let us not be hasty. The odds are on our side.
And time runs out. In a few days, we'll open the council debate on our recommendation.
Yes, our recommendation.
Your plan, I must admit, was clever. Zelda, you'd make a great field marshal.
Ah, Julie, that was enjoyable. We've never tasted nutrients and liquid like this before.
You sure like the wine, too.
Oh, the red liquid? Now, I don't think our friends back home know about this. What was that tasty little dish with the red sauce?
Chicken cacciatore.
Chicken cacciatore?
Chicken, you know.
Oh, you mean those cute little things with the feathers.
It was alive. Once.
Emo, knock it off.
Listen, before going to bed, would you like a nightcap?
No, thanks. I sleep in the nude.
I like that liquid we had before dinner. Let's have some of that.
Yes. Well, then why don't you go into the next room and make yourself comfortable, okay? And I'll get it for you. Good. Well, do you want soda or water this time or straight?
Always.
Me too.
Here you are.
Good. Good.
Want some more?
Oh, yes, please. But no water or soda this time. Or straight either.
I guess I was thirsty. Thirsty.
It's funny stuff, this stuff. But I like it. I think.
Oh, my face feels funny.
My thinking mechanism is acting oddly.
Are you all right?
Are you supposed to feel funny?
Like, Emo, haven't you ever had a drink before?
Not like this.
I feel funny, too. Like laughing.
You know, I think both of you are drunk.
We don't have liquids like this on our planet.
Well, we!
I'm just going to sit here.
Oh, no. I can't believe it. You're acting like little boys, both of you.
Emo, sit down before you go down.
Oh, now the room is moving.
I'm so embarrassed. I feel terrible. I didn't realize you had never had a drink before. I'm going to go make you some nice hot coffee that'll soak you.
Hail, King Kroger, a merry soul is he. He took the queen and he had a son, and Zuko lived happily. Oh, hail, King Kroger, a merry soul, a soul, a merry
and a queen,
soul, and a merry soul, and happy, hey!
Forgive us for disturbing you, Your Highness, but the Council would like to meet to discuss possible alternatives.
It does no harm to think about alternatives, my lord.
The alternative, sire.
The Council grows anxious.
Very anxious.
We must be prepared for unpredictable things that might happen.
Nonsense. With Zig and Emo, they're always predictable. I know at this very moment, they're working diligently to resolve this matter.
Oh, Zig, where am I? Oh, no, we've been captured. Oh, my head. Oh,
come on, Emo. What is it?
We've been taken prisoner. And we've been tortured. Oh, no. Oh, they've been beating on my head. Oh, the pain. Oh, the pain.
Relax, Emo. Everything is going to be all right. We're on Earth in Julie's house.
Julie?
Where are we? Oh, we're spinning in space. Oh, my head.
My tongue. They've done something to my tongue.
They must have put something in that juice.
See? That little thing?
Snap out of it. We've got work to do. Up.
All right. Oh, not too fast. No, not too fast.
Come on. We've got to check out Julie's navel.
How are we going to do that? You want to walk up to her and say, excuse me, Julie, we have to examine your belly button?
Don't be silly. We'll go to a room, we'll hide, and then we'll look.
Zig, it's not right. Julie wouldn't like that.
I don't have time to argue with you.
Zig.
Listen, she's in the kitchen. Now's our chance. Come on.
Oh. Hey, Zig. What'd you see?
Nothing. And you?
I was too nervous. I kept my eyes closed. Well, what do we do now?
We'll have to go to that window again.
Oh, no. No,
what's the matter?
No. I'm naked.
You're not naked. Come on.
I'm not going outside like this.
Oh, Emo. Put this on.
How do you do that?
Come on, just...
No, that's backwards.
This time, you hold me up.
Fine. Let's hurry. This is embarrassing. Get your foot up. No, not my face.
Okay.
All right. Okay, right. You got it?
Still measuring? Oh, I know. You were just getting dressed. You fell out of the window.
See, it was his turn.
Well, I mean...
What are you doing now?
Julie, I can explain it all.
I'm very sorry. It's all right. Everything will be all right, officer.
Yeah, well, lady, just remember there's children in the neighborhood.
Really, officer? I want to talk to you right now. Come on. Hurry up.
both children. You're more infantile than I would ever have imagined. First, you can't even hold your liquor. You can't even talk about the bathroom without going through a whole number. I am so disappointed in both of you. You've got a lot of growing up to do. And now this. I can't believe it. Here you were peeking at me. Like two adolescents. I mean, I can't believe it. How can two men be so childish, immature, perverted? If you only can think of women as sex objects. There. Does that satisfy your prurient interest? I think you better leave now.
She's got one. She's actually got one.
See, I can't believe it. King Kruger will make us ministers for this.
Don't you ever come back here again.
I warned you.
Maybe it would have been better just to come right out with it instead of sneaking around.
What do we do?
I don't know. And she passed every test. Loyalty.
Good hostess.
Cleanliness.
Morality.
She even had the mark. The great gods of Zuko must have planned it.
It's destiny.
We've got to tell her.
Well, here comes our chance.
Let's catch up with her and tell her everything.
If she'll listen.
Julie! Please!
Can we have a word with you?
Don't bother me!
Julie, we can explain everything.
I'm not interested. Look,
the reason that we were acting so funny is because...
See, what Emo is trying to say is that one of the qualifications for selecting a woman was that she have a special beauty mark.
What?
It's a long story, but you have to have a beauty mark in that special place.
Right where you have one.
Oh, is it more of your nonsense?
No!
I can't be bothered.
Julie, listen.
I can't.
The reason that we seem so odd to you is that we're really and honestly from another planet.
That's obvious.
We mean it, Julie.
Yeah.
We're from a planet 28,000 light years from Earth. The planet Zuko.
We were sent here to select a queen for our king, our beloved King Kroger the Eighth.
That's right. We tried to tell you, but you wouldn't believe us.
You guys are really something. I've heard it all.
Julie, one thing we would not do is tell a lie.
Oh, no. A lie is he's against Zuko's religion.
We are serious. We were sent here as envoys to find a woman just like you.
That's right. That's why we seem strange to you. We don't know all of your Earth ways.
At least let us prove it to you.
Oh, you two belong in a loony bin.
Wait.
What?
Wait. We will show you our spacecraft. We will show you pictures of our land and king.
Yes, I'll show you pictures of my pet Zarnok.
Please, Julie, believe us. Let us show you.
He's a cute little guy. He's green with little furry wings. You'd love him.
Emo, please.
Look, we can't convince you. We promise we'll never, ever bother you again.
Our king will see to it that we never bother anyone again.
Well, maybe I might be as crazy as both of you. But I want to see what this is all about.
Our pleasure.
Yeah.
Your royal queenship.
Well, my counselors, have you heard the news? What did I tell you about Zig and Emo?
What, my lord?
What news?
The news is great. Emo and Zig have confirmed that my lovely Earth candidate has passed every test put to her. Loyalty, honesty, intelligence,
morality.
And the mark?
Yes, the mark.
To the detail.
You are sure?
You have proof?
It cannot be.
Prepare for the wedding. Ah, my counsel, how I thank you for your insistence. For without it, I would have never met my lovely, perfect Earth woman. I wait with anticipation her arrival. Counsel, you were right about your king needing a wife. And what a woman. That face. Those eyes. That figure. So soft.
Can you two blame me for not taking you guys seriously? I mean, you couldn't even drive my car. Are you sure you can handle this flying saucer?
My grandfather taught me how to drive.
He's the best.
Maybe this is going to be the greatest adventure of all. Maybe I should consider marriage. But of course, I haven't committed myself. Understand that? I think I'd like to wait and see what happens.
Uh-huh. A toast to the future queen of Zuko. To my beloved, beautiful, soft wife-to-be, Queen Julie the First.
Queen Julie!
And may the gods of Zuko bless King Kroger.
And your beautiful Queen Julie the First.
Julie the First.
And sire, to your many heirs. And tell me, sire, what is it you're looking forward to most in your new queen?
Mordo, seriously, I've always admired the old-fashioned qualities of Earth women. They understand who is the master, and they are proud of the role as women, right, Mordo?
I wonder how your civilization views women.
Well, King Kroger still likes old-fashioned women. You know, like Earth women.
Well, you'll probably want to spend hours talking about philosophy and adventure, galactic travel, romance. Oh, it'll be so nice to get away from the TV.
Julie, I...
It'll be quite an experience, don't you think?
The Zuko women have become too liberated for me, is that correct, Your Highness?
Very well put, Zelda. You see, you've all lost sight of the fundamental simplicity and the purpose of women.
Tell us more, my lord.
To serve her man with dedication, without question. To satisfy his every desire.
Every desire?
To not hide her feminine charms, to enjoy her sexual role.
Hear, hear.
I can't wait to see this pinup queen with her full bosoms and empty head.
We still have 7 cycles of time to go before we arrive. Would you care for a substance pill?
Oh, no thanks. I'm looking forward to preparing your king one of my home-cooked meals.
We no longer eat meals on Zuko.
We take substance pills.
The king should eat natural foods. They're better for him. Well, I'll see to that.
Julie, I advise you. The king does not like to be told what to do.
Zig, I wouldn't be doing my job as a wife if I didn't contribute my ideas and feelings.
I wish I could agree with you.
You know, King Kroger is really going to enjoy a woman's touch.
Mordo, to women, bless them all.
Beg your pardon, sire, to Earth women.
Earth women.
Here, here.
Here's to the future Queen of Zuko, my beloved, beautiful, soft wife-to-be, Queen Julie the First.
Here, here.
Beautiful lady. Our first king fell in love with a woman for your world also.
But am I the first woman you've known? Or were there others?
Oh, you're the first. And after being with you, the only woman I'll ever know throughout the universe.
You're truly romantic, sir.
I've dreamt of meeting a perfect woman such as you. That face, those eyes, that nose, those lips.
You're my knight in shining armor. I too have yearned for someone just like you.
Beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of God to bring King Kroger VIII of Zuko and his queen-to-be, Julie of Earth, together in holy matrimony. It is a great honor for me to perform this ceremony as I did for your father, Kroger VII. And now, dear Julie of Earth, do you agree to take Kroger Zuko for your king, lord, and master?
I do.
And now, dear king, do you agree to treat Julie with kindness, affection, tenderness, and love, as you would any loyal subject.
Of course, I do.
By virtue of the power vested in me as Archbishop of Zuko, I hereby decree that King Kroger VIII of Zuko and Queen Julia I of Earth are hereby married.
Long live the king! Long live the king!
Oh, what a wonderful day. I love all your fans, Emo and Zig, and all the others are so nice. And you, my darling.
You are my perfect woman.
I hope I won't disappoint you in any way.
And I'll never disappoint you. I can't believe I've lived my whole life without you. You're so beautiful. Those eyes, that nose, those soft lips.
You're so romantic. Why don't we?
Sounds delightful, my queen.
My pleasure, my king. Evening, my darling king. Is there anything more I can do for you? I am going to prepare a beautiful breakfast for my beautiful king. Except aren't you sitting too close to the TV? It isn't good for your eyes.
Oh, beautiful kid, what a play!
My king needs a good hearty breakfast to get his day going.
Pass it! Pass it!
Darling.
My program.
No, darling. Your queen would like to know if you would prefer scrambled or fried eggs.
Scrambled what? I've already had my food pill for the day.
Now, to keep your strength up, you need your protein, dear.
Not now.
Well, I'm just going to have to look after you.
Fine, later.
Anything you wish, dear. I'm going to surprise you.
The Belzar seems to be working very well.
Yes, we have managed at last to sign an agreement with them. We have agreed to sell Letho to them, and in exchange we have promised to import their sensual essences. It's a fair exchange.
Very good.
It's very good.
Oh, careful, excuse me.
My dear queen, come in. We were just finishing a matter or two.
Oh, thank you.
I promise I won't bother you.
I have received reports that some of the young women are still insisting they would like to carry their babies until birth. They're envying the mechanical mothers.
There's always a few in every crowd.
Do you mean women aren't given the choice to make their own decisions about delivering babies?
It's been Zuko's way for centons now.
And it's proven much more practical.
Well, if there are no more serious things to discuss, I suggest we adjourn.
I so decree
that... Do you mean women aren't at least given the choice? Isn't it more democratic to let mothers make their own decisions? After all, carrying a child is part of motherhood.
Oh, my dear queen. The matter was debated for centons. The kings didn't like their women running around looking pregnant. It wasn't aesthetically pleasing to them, so they...
Well, I'll just have to talk to the king about that.
I see a battle on the horizon.
It's a closed matter. None of your concern, and I don't want to discuss it again. Is that understood?
Yes, Your Highness, but the matter isn't totally closed. Just temporarily. I have a lovely surprise for you. Yeah. Come, come. Goodbye. You ready?
All right, what's your surprise?
A big surprise. Open your eyes.
What's happened? What's become of all my things, my pictures?
My TV!
First, I think you watch a little bit too much television. It isn't good for your eyes.
What?
And, well, I don't think that we need all of these posters of the pinup girls around now that you're married. It makes me a little jealous.
But I like them. Besides, you have nothing to be jealous about.
Come here.
What?
Come here. Relax.
On this?
Right here.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Oh, what is this? Get this thing out of here. It's a pool. Get rid of it. And what are those things hanging over there?
Curtains, my love. They go over windows to give the room a warmer touch.
We don't have any windows. And my bed. It's different. Something's odd. Mm-hmm. Oh, what the heck is this thing?
Isn't it wonderful? It's a water pen.
Oh, what? What on earth is it for? Where does it come from?
I ordered it from home. Wait, my lord, till this evening. I'll give you a complete demonstration. You'll see its advantages.
Oh. Julie, This is all very interesting. But I find it absolutely absurd that anyone would want to keep running around and around like this in a circle. And that waterbed is making me seasick.
Good for you, my darling. Oh. It keeps you in shape and healthy.
If it doesn't kill me first.
Come on, let's go. I prepared a relaxing and quiet evening for us.
I don't know if I can take another one.
I prepared a nice meal. And afterwards, we'll listen to some music. Then, the waterbed.
Julie, I've had a very difficult day with the council. I'm just not hungry.
But my dear King, I've made something special. You need to eat.
I'm sorry, Julia. I just like to sit and watch TV.
But that's all you've been doing the past few nights. Come on. What's wrong? Huh? What's bothering you?
Nothing's bothering me. What makes you think something is bothering me? I'm just tired. I've had it today.
You know something? You love the TV more than me.
No, I would just like to watch TV and do nothing.
I've tried to please you.
Julie.
You don't appreciate me.
Oh, come on, Julie. Of course I appreciate you.
No, you don't.
Okay. Let's have that romantic dinner.
Don't let me get in the way of your relaxation.
Julie, I'm sick and tired of you interfering in my affairs. Now, I let you take down my pictures and get rid of my television. You overfeed me, overindulge me. I'd just like to be left alone for one lousy minute.
Yes, sir.
The ministers have all agreed, sir, that this is a very good treaty for Belzar.
It will also open up the possibility of a military alliance. We can use their highly sophisticated laser cannon when I put my invasion of Beelzebub into effect.
Emmett, you're always thinking war, Mordo. It keeps me young.
We have no plans to invade anybody, Mordo.
I can dream, can't I?
Sire, isn't that our queen coming in on the VDCOM?
What? Cut off the sound, Mordo.
Yes, Your Highness.
See, I believe that a woman could be missing something, something very natural and important to her as a mother, when not allowed to carry the child herself. There creates a bond of closeness. There's nothing wrong with looking pregnant. But you see, that's my opinion as a woman.
Gods.
You see, I believe that a woman...
Get me Zig any more this instant.
...could be missing something, something Quick. Very natural
yes,
and important to her as a mother. Of course, if the king heard me talking like this, he wouldn't exactly agree with me, but...
My queen, the king got very upset when you went on intercom telecast and said all those things about mothers and natural childbirth. You upset things. You should have talked to Emo or me first. You created a small revolution.
I'm sorry. I mean, the king agreed to allow me to express myself. I guess I was wrong. I should never again come here.
Now, don't say that, Julie.
Anita. I mean, the king isn't even being flexible. He doesn't appreciate me. I thought I was supposed to contribute something. But now I've got the king, the council, everyone angry at me, and... you're being blamed for it.
I will survive, I hope.
I feel like I'm in everyone's way. Don't you see, I just want to make him happy, be helpful, and be appreciated.
He loves you.
Are you sure?
Sure he does.
He never comes home to his quarters anymore.
Look, his cousin Prince Edward is visiting Zuko. Why don't you prepare a really great dinner? Make the king happy and Prince Edward envious.
Right, and afterwards, say you want to spend an evening watching TV with him. That would really please him, Julie.
An evening of TV?
We know how you feel, but try it.
For our sakes, too, Julie. Please?
I'll do it. I don't know what I'd do if you two weren't here.
Where is Prince Edward? We should start without him. Never once since I've known the man has he ever been on time. Not once.
Ah. Cousin.
Please, all sit. We're a little late. Well, I wish to welcome you, Prince Edward, my cousin, and my faithful minister, Mizu, my queen.
I love the daisy wallpaper in the war room. It was an inspiration.
Yes, as I was about to say, my queen wishes to honor your visit by preparing one of her own earth meals.
Well, I am quite honored, Your Highness, and I have read about earth food. I find it terribly exciting to be sharing these primitive offerings.
Well, the king asked me to prepare one of the more popular ones on earth.
You must tell Prince Edward about your planet. He knows so little about it.
Oh, it's beautiful. There's streams and trees, flowers, mountains. I suppose anything other than its natural beauty might seem somewhat primitive to you.
I think it would be wonderful to enjoy the natural things in life. Nature, food, other sensual pleasures. Oh, I can't wait to taste it.
It's called spaghetti.
Yes.
It's an Italian dish. It's been enjoyed by millions of people all around the earth. Mm. You just take your spoon and a fork, wind it around the fork like this, and enjoy.
I can't seem to...
Oh, patience, my dear.
Interesting little strands of... whatever.
Billy, he sees me.
Oh, yes. You on the Zuko affair program last week.
Yes.
Could you elaborate on your position on childbearing?
As opposed to the modern mechanical method, I feel a woman should have a choice.
Yes, I agree. I was telling some people, friends of mine, women should have a choice. No one should have the right to legislate such a thing.
I agree.
What do you think, King Kroger? What do I think? What do I think?
I think I should speak with you, my dear queen, alone.
Excuse us. We'll be right then.
What does you think, Kroger?
I apologize. What more can I do? I just got carried away. I'm sorry. Will you calm down for a moment?
Calm down, you say?
It isn't enough that you almost created a women's revolution with your public comments on childbearing, but to make a fool out of me in front of that excuse for a man. He is the biggest gossip in this galaxy. In case you haven't heard, I happen to be the king, the absolute ruler of this land. Counteracting the king's decree is... In the days of Kroger the First, you would have been sent to the block. Sent to the block!
How kind of your lordship to spare me my neck.
You made a fool out of me in there.
Well, you're making a fool out of yourself right here.
How dare you speak to me that way?
You know, it would do you a lot of good if someday you didn't get your own way.
Now listen to me,
if you had to consider the feelings and opinions of others.
I have
to wait for something instead of instant gratification of your wishes.
You do not.
Maybe you'd learn what it's like to be patient. You'd learn humility. Maybe you'd learn what it's like to be a member of the human race.
Oh!
So send me away as punishment for loving you.
Cousin Kroger, aren't you going to join us?
Zig, Emo, my dear Mordo, my wise Zelda, Tok, my faithful advisor, Mizu, all Sith. I've called a special meeting of the council for a very important matter. I've made a very big mistake, and I don't know how to admit it. Council, you were right. I should have married a woman from our own galaxy. A woman who understands the relationship between a husband and wife. I wish to dissolve my marriage to Queen Julie.
Sire, the ancient rules governing such an issue make the matter a bit difficult.
Get to the point.
Only under certain circumstances may a king be freed of his marriage vows, or when another man is willing to take her, your queen, as his wife. Then and only then may your marriage be dissolved.
Who made up that rule?
Your great ancestor, Kroger the First.
The problem we face, sire, is that no man would dare accept Queen Julie as his wife for fear of the king's retribution.
You know your retribution.
Retribution? Nonsense.
Sire, no man dare take that chance.
Is this so, Zig?
I fear it's true, sire.
Mordo, my friend, is there something you can do?
I'd gladly take her, sire. But I don't have anyone who'd take my wife.
If I might suggest, we send an emissary back to Earth to find a suitable and legitimate husband, a man of her own kind, who would take her as his wife.
That shouldn't be difficult, sire. She is certainly the most intelligent and beautiful woman that I've ever seen.
Yes, she certainly is. Zig, Emo, leave immediately. Find a man on Earth acceptable for Julie. A man who appreciates her beauty. Those eyes. Those lips. That figure. So soft.
Sire, in the meantime, perhaps you could give the queen another chance. She's a good woman. She could change, you know.
She could.
Zig, I do love her more than any woman I've ever known, but I just can't live with her. It's more than a king can take. As sorry as I am, it is decided.
Zig, Emo, you've been avoiding me for days. What's the matter? You don't like your old friend anymore?
We've been busy, Julie.
Oh, yes, very. We have work to do. It's a special assignment.
Oh, well, you're going somewhere.
Yes, we have to go on a special mission for the king.
Well, that's funny. He didn't mention anything. Of course, he's been avoiding me, too. Listen, I have something wonderful to tell you both.
Julie, we'd really like to talk to you, but we're late.
All right, I understand. You're in a hurry. Well, maybe later.
Sure. Bye, Julie.
Here. Listen, will you call me when you get back? Because I do have something very, very special to tell you about. Okay.
Yeah.
I would advise you as I would any great king. You must do it alone. You should tell her yourself. It is your duty. Your duty as king. May the gods of Zuko be with you.
Thank you.
want to speak with you.
Yes, my lord?
This is very difficult to say.
I'm glad you've come. I've really missed you.
Well, Julia.
Yes?
Julie.
Yes?
Your king, King Kroger the Eighth, has something to tell you.
And I have something to tell you, sire.
Julie. First, I've made a decision. Although I'm king, I do have feelings. And I love you. But I also have my duty to my people, my council, my land, my position as ruler. I want you to understand that, Julie. Although, I do love you. Julie, I'm speaking with you. I said I love you. Is there anything you want to say?
Yes. I'm pregnant.
Well, you're king. You're what?
Pregnant.
Julie, you didn't tell me. Why didn't you tell me?
I just found out.
Oh, now you tell me. Oh, Julie, dear Julie. Oh, what am I going to do? I have to think.
I'm really sorry about the terrible mess I created the other night at the dinner.
Julie, there are things we have to talk about now.
Yes.
God, so Zuko, I hope I'm not too late.
You're never too late.
Julie. Sig Emo.
Julie really loves King. King really loves her. It doesn't seem fair. Zig, maybe we could just forget the whole thing and say we couldn't find anybody.
No, that wouldn't work either.
Yeah, Zirconian can't lie. Look, Emo, here comes somebody now.
Here comes now.
Hi there, what's up?
Hey, what's going down?
Excuse me, sir. Are you married?
What? Who are you? What do you want?
Are you married?
Me? No, why? What's going on?
Have we got a girl for you?
You'll limit your TV viewings, we agreed.
Agreed. Now, you have to promise not to make any public speeches without checking with me first. Is that agreed to?
Agreed.
Your Highness.
Don't bother me.
This is Mordo. There's a message. It's important, sire. It's Zig. And it looks like they, found someone.
Well, stall them.
Stall them, sire?
Tell them, they may just have to wait. I'm in conference.
They seem anxious. When will you know for sure?
Call me in the morning. I'm negotiating now.
At last, I come before affairs of state.
Darling, you are part of the whole affair.
Sweetheart. Will you always love me?
What do you mean?
Will you still love me and think I'm beautiful while I'm carrying your child?
Mordo, I want to talk with you.
Sire, are you there?
Tomorrow.
And so it was that King Kroger the Eighth and his lovely Queen Julie would carry on the dynasty. And this marriage made in heaven, like all marriages, would be filled with as many moments of happiness as it would be unexpected surprises from his queen. So it was written.
Thank you.
Thank you.